What do you know before you get here?
The only stuff we know right now is what you guys know, and that, you know, he told us that from the get-go that we'd be the first people to know whatever he decides, and you know, we're going to keep him to his word, and, you know, we've trusted him this far, and you know, we're going to believe what he says, and, you know, as far as the team goes, you know, we see him as one of the best coaches in the nation, if not the best, so obviously we want to keep him. We understand it's a business, and at the same time, you know, we want him here, so we feel he's going to make the right decision, whatever he does. So.
No players meeting this afternoon, or was there one?
No, we haven't had one yet. This is the first time we've got together. We had a meeting Monday and kind of got to let go for finals week, and back here tonight. So as far as everything goes, we're finding out the same stuff you guys are tonight. So
everybody's pretty interested. Have you had any contact with him all week?
No, he hasn't said anything to me. He hasn't contacted me. You know, I've been in contact with a lot of the seniors, just seeing if they've heard anything. And obviously Marty, and Marty hasn't heard anything either. And obviously Marty's pretty confident that he's not going anywhere from what he's told Marty. So I guess him and Marty have talked. But like I said, I'm in the same boat you guys are, and eager to get this thing started tonight.
Did he say anything to you or the team as a whole about not leaving last week?
Yeah, last week, Tuesday we were practicing with Pittsburgh. He said that he loves it here, and he loves his team, and loves coaching here, and his family loves it here. So. From that talk, you know, last week, we hope that's enough that he's wanting to stay. You know, we obviously know that Notre Dame can offer him a lot, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I think his family likes it here. And I think he's got it, you know, not just this year, but, you know, the next few years, I think we got a great group of guys coming back.
After saying that, what was the next conversation when he did let you guys know that, hey, he was going to listen, you know, before he left this week? I know we were told that you guys were told by him that I'm going to listen and going to talk. How was that conversation? What did he say after telling you last week of practice that he loved it?
Monday he came in, and obviously, you know, the players aren't stupid, and they hear all the stuff that's going on too. So we're all talking in the locker room, and he basically came in, and before addressing anything else, he said he's going to be up front with you. He said he's going to listen to what Notre Dame has to say and go from there. He said, you know, it's a business, and he said anytime you're present with an offer, you're going to listen, you know, whether that's going to help out where he's at right now or help out down the road. So like I said, he's been up front with us thus far, and I see him doing that tonight too.
What's the mood of the team tonight, Tony?
I think anxious and eager. You know, I mean, obviously, like I said, we listen to the radio and we listen to the news, you know, just as much as everybody else. And it's probably a little harder on us because we're getting the calls from our friends and family wanting to know, you know, what's really happening. And it's hard because we don't know either. So I think the biggest thing with the team is we just want to, you know, find something out. And because obviously we got a pretty big game to get ready for.
If he's leaving, would you still want him to coach the bowl game?
I think that's something that the team would have to sit down and discuss. You know, it'd be hard just knowing that. You know, after the game, he wouldn't be here with us anymore. So I think that's something we'd have to sit down and obviously see, you know, what with the administration, who they'd bring in or if it was someone, you know, in-house that they'd keep. So, you know, all that speculation until after tonight. So after tonight, we'll know a little bit more.
How much does this dampen what should be a celebration tonight?
I think a little bit. You know, obviously, you know, not knowing what he's deciding yet or, if, you know, if he's going to make an announcement or not. You know, this team's got a lot to be proud of. And obviously going 12-0 and back-to-back Big East championship. So I think the group we got, you know, we understand that this is a celebration tonight of what we accomplished. And then, you know, get back next week and get ready for the Sugar Bowl.
Do you feel betrayed anyway? You get this great season, and now there's still all this speculation. Is he still talking to
you? I wouldn't say betrayed, just because of the fact that you know, from the get-go, Coach has been honest with us. You know, from when he got here to now, you know, anything that he feels, you know, he needs to get across, he gets across. And I think he's done that this time. You know, I don't think he's going behind our backs and making any deals or any choices. So we'll just have to see tonight.
Are you excited for him in any way?
Yeah, I mean, I'm excited just to see what happens. You know, obviously, you know, if he were to decide to stay, I mean, that's a huge step for the program and a huge step for the city of Cincinnati, you know. And I don't think that Cincinnati should be a stepping stone anymore for coaches. Obviously, you know, we're a second, a foot away from playing for a national championship. So, I mean, it's not like you can go somewhere else and be in better contention than we are. So, I mean, I think just as far as what Cincinnati is, I mean, this is a great place to be.
Thanks, Tony.
Yeah. Tony, thank you.